All right, it's another beautiful day. Andrew and I are out here doing some GPS work in preparation for the Snowbike Gathering. Let's ride. That is no way to treat a company vehicle. If I get my foot right up here under the handlebar.
One of the topics we want to cover today is managing engine temperature. So these dirt bikes are obviously built for dirt, not snow, so it's really tough to get them up to operating temperature, especially when there's lots of this fluffy stuff kicking around. We've built something that goes in the outside of our radiators, and this can be pulled off, so it's blocking off air from going inside. And ta-da! Now this would be, this is like a little blanket stopping the air from going through. Take that away, your bike's going to run a little bit cooler. You also see down here we have a big snow deflector shield, and this is keeping snow from just blowing in on the engine as well. So you want to get your engine temperature up to what, 180, 200. Once you get like 210, 215, maybe be thinking about cooling it down a bit. Ani here is running hot today, so I'm not running these. I'm watching my temperature gauge, and every now and then I'm getting out and I'm just shoveling a pile of snow on the bike to bring the temperature back down. That's it.
So in addition to what Scott was just saying, I'm also running an engine blanket on Helga. It's a great tool for building temperature. The one pitfall to this is if you do start to see your engine temperature starting to spike, this thing's a little bit harder to take off.
If you like to film your snow biking adventures, a great place to put your GoPro or other action camera right on your chin. So I can point my chin wherever I want to get a picture of and follow my buddy over there down to my feet. Plus, you also get good audio. Actually hear me. Dango chin mount available for the snowbike shop. Woo! What are you doing? Why are you falling on me? Go away.
Give me your foot bag.
Okay, he's taking me out.
I have a muscle cramp.
I'm getting out of here. Get off me.
I'm all seized up.
Man, I can hold my bike. You're always so graceful.
With the swan.
Is this going to take a while? So yeah, we're out on Nelson Mountain. It's awesome out here. Right down there, we've driven up to the end of the road to map things out for the snowbike gathering. And all in there is a big, huge burn that is really popular with snowmobilers and snowbikers. We'll go check it out.
Welcome to the burn.
So we stopped here to take some nice pictures with the camera. Caught Andrew coming across, and he was gonna do a nice big wheelie for me. I'll get a picture and insert it so you can see what actually happened. Now he gets to dig himself out. Looking for Andrew. He took an unfortunate path in here. There he is.
Whoa, sick trick, dude.
Creek
crossing catwalks right now. Sure. Yeah. Look at you down there. Okay, I'll see you in like half an hour. Bye. You guys have got to check this out. So see these slings? They're these fine slings that are down attached to the ski. We got two of them linked together. But look at where I am, like way up here on good ground, and I'm going to be able to pull on this thing. I can put it around my body and really give it a good pull. And it's just an amazing tool for like $11. We each have two of these there. Did I say amazing?
Amazing.
Ready? Hut! Yeah! Nope, not even moving. Okay. So we're gonna have to dig this out.
Running the giant loop Mojave bags for years on our dirt bikes and on our snow bikes. It is by far the best storage solution we've found for snow biking, especially. Get some of that weight off your back onto the bike. Giant loop Mojave bags, pick them up at the snowbikeshop.com.
It's just so cool in here.
Excited to try out is a giant loop gas bladder. It's a soft case for hauling gas into the backcountry. Anybody who's running a Yeti knows how much trouble we're having getting those formed gas cans. We're still waiting for ours from last year. So we wanted to try something different. This keeps the weight low. It's on the track, not on our backs. Let's see how it works. Awesome.
That was a lot of fun.
What a great area. It's really undulating terrain, tons of stuff like that, lots of downed logs. Of course, that means it's pretty hazardous too. You could go off one log and stuff it right into another one. Fold your bike in half.